On May 24th, 1869, a one-armed Civil War veteran named John Wesley Powell pushed off into the Green River at Green River, Wyoming, and began an audacious and tantalizingly brave river trip. His roughneck crew consisted of 9 men, who, along with a small wood shop for repairing boats and hewing new oars, scientific equipment like barometers, thermometers, and chronometers, 10 months' worth of food, and a 3-gallon keg of whiskey, piled into 4 very overloaded wooden boats. They arrived at danger quickly. On June 9th, the men entered a canyon, which they named Lador, and soon had one of their boats smashed to pieces in a rapid. It is difficult today to understand the magnitude of Powell's trip. Over the course of that summer of 1869, Powell and his men would lose much of their food, bust oars, break boats, make new oars, argue. And on one occasion, Powell nearly fell from a cliff, but was rescued in the nick of time when one of his men removed his jeans, lowered them to Powell, and pulled him to safety. The Powell expedition did many things too voluminous to discuss here. By the end of August, though, Powell and all but 3 of his men, who hiked out of the canyon in the final days of the trip, arrived at the confluence of the Virgin River and were soon in the caring hands of Mormon settlers. For all river people who came after Powell, this seminal expedition can be pinpointed as the critical mass of modern man's intrusion into that intriguing area on old maps that the Western historian, Utah boy, and Powell biographer Wallace Stegner noted thusly, quote, "The hinterlands were a tantalizing blank marked in a cartographer's neat lettering, unexplored."